So good morning, I'm George. I'm here to present to you and introduce our cyber-physical detection and response solution for smart manufacturers. We call it our CPDR solution. So, downtime is the absolute nightmare in case of digital manufacturers. With an average of 300 hours of unplanned downtime per year, which practically means more than 5 hours per week. And this response, this is linked directly to the bottom line with an average loss in the case of a fast-moving consumer goods manufacturer being 39,000 euros per hour of unplanned downtime, which means that at the end of the day results to a multi-million loss, taking into account that in case of a cyber attack, this downtime can last for up to 2 weeks. But let's see, what's the root cause of this? Let's ask, literally speaking, the $1 million question. When it comes to downtime, do manufacturers know whether this is because of a cyber threat, a system fault, or equipment failure? And how long does it take to know this? This literally defines the response whether they should shut down the whole plant or not. We have made this question to several manufacturers, and it is very surprising to see that it takes more than 1 week, sometimes 2 weeks, to understand the root cause in case of downtime. And this is because they rely exclusively either on IT monitoring systems or OT monitoring systems without being able to connect the dots between the two. We do that, and we can provide an impact-aware response to this $1 million question by introducing our cyber-physical detection and response technology, which combines cyber and physical data using an AI engine for spotting anomalies. How does it work? By analyzing cyber and physical data, we are able to spot anomalies. And by classifying and correlating anomalies and threats, we provide a root cause cascading analysis leading to an impact-aware response in a very plain language that any production engineer can easily comprehend. So we have a plug-and-play solution at the end of the day, which is installable in less than 1 day, doesn't require any additional infrastructure or in-house security teams, which makes this an excellent choice when it comes to the SME market, which is currently underserved. So our tangible impact, we turn detection and response from days and weeks to seconds and minutes. And this, at the bottom line, because this is what matters at the end of the day, means saving over 6 million euros per manufacturer per year. We are targeting a very lucrative and emerging market that includes high-tech manufacturing companies with existing needs of Industry 3.5 or 4.0. This is a growing market that grows with something like 10% per year, while our SOM is currently 1 billion euros. Our market traction is already promising. We have already successfully completed 3 POCs, and we have another 3 lined up for the next couple of months. One of the POCs was a paid one with IBM that led to having our solution integrated in IBM's CP4S suite, and we are actually doing now the same. We are discussing with AWS to become an AWS partner. Our business board, we are offering our solution via a licensing subscription model of a 12-month period at least. And we are following a very fair pricing model, meaning that the price depends on the number of devices that will be monitored or the data, the volume of data that will be monitored. So this takes us to 3 tiers, the light, the standard, and the enterprise, starting from 30,000 euros, 50,000 euros, and 100,000 euros per year, depending on the size of the beneficiary. And we are offering this solution via direct sales, integrators, and solution providers. We have the team to pull this off because we tick all the boxes and we have the necessary skill set for this demanding challenge. Our growth projections are based on our current market traction and POCs. And we are looking at 55 paying customers by the end of 2024 and 4.4 million euros of ARR. So we are raising 2.5 million right now for accomplishing this plan and for being able to bolster our team, to widen our market penetration and to move from an MVP to a fully commercial product. Thanks a lot.
Thank you. We have some questions. Please, Willy.
Yeah, thanks for presentation. One question. How do you train your system to find anomalies in the first step?
The AI core is benchmarking the full, let's say, the normal production cycle. It learns how a production line operates, and it benchmarks the normal, let's say, process in from seconds to hours, depending on the complexity of the production cycle. And then every, let's say, every reflection of the production and the physical processes is benchmarked against this, let's say, normal threshold.
And if you go to customers, who is ordering you? Is it the IT department or is it the manufacturing department?
Very good question, because actually we are looking at two different personas. The OT department understands better what we are doing, but they need also to consult the IT department. So at the end of the day, we have the OT deciding and the IT signing eventually, because all, let's say, such solutions are run or are under the responsibility of the IT teams. But our main user, persona, and beneficiary is the OT manager and the OT department.
Yeah, I have a question. Yeah. So do you operate inline, or is it not in line? I mean, and what are the response actions that you can take?
The response actions that we take right now are provided through the CP4S suite of IBM. We are building our own response system as we speak, but response now is provided through the suite of IBM. So at that level, without, let's say, having involved the IBM suite at all, we can provide a plain response, a notification to the production manager saying exactly what they should do. But together with the IBM, as part of the IBM suite, then our solution can also take action. So shutting down the plant, or isolating a port, or pulling out a conveyor belt from the whole system. This is doable, and this is something that right now is done through the IBM suite, but it is in our plans to have our own response system also in the next period of time.
And is it in line? So do you deploy in line?
Our deployment is very, I mean, we can deploy on-site, cloud-based, or hybrid. We just tap in a data collector, a probe. We upcycle data, and we can use this probe if it is okay and if it is allowed and if it is agreed with the end customer, also for response purposes. But it is a totally passive, let's say, connection to the system. We do not interfere, we do not download data.
Talking about that, what is the difference? How do you adapt your models in order to ensure that you capture what is the key data element that you need for the analysis? Because at the end, I suppose the OT technology, sorry, I don't know if you can hear me, is going to defer what is the data that you are going to need and how exactly you adapt that data to really track what is going on.
Our solution can comprehend any typical communication protocol, starting from OPC UA and all different protocols right now. So by collecting this data and by classifying, upcycling, reading it, we can always benchmark it against the production cycle, because even data coming from physical devices, let's say a robotic arm or a conveyor belt, it is easy for us to analyze and comprehend because they follow a specific communication protocol that is readable, let's say, by our AI core.
One question related to how to demonstrate to the manufacturer or to the potential buyer that the return of the security investment that they are going to make.
Two things. First of all, we ask them literally this question, and this is how we ended up putting this on our pitch deck, because it draws attention and it makes them understand that what we are doing has actual financial impact for them. So we ask this question, and the response we get is, we don't know, it takes 2 weeks. So we say, okay, how about having this response in seconds? So we explain to them that by simply reducing their downtime from 60, let's say, to 80%, they can end up by saving some millions. So this is an obvious response when it comes to return on investment. And also, in case of users that have already existing solutions in place, we do not substitute any solution. We work alongside. So if, let's say, somebody has the Nozomi solution or the Clarity solution, it's not that they should throw this away, but they simply integrate their umbrella protection by having our solution working alongside the existing one. And again, this is another point, because they do not get rid of everything, so they do not lose an investment that they have already made.
Talking about the license price, is how exactly is articulated? Is based on number of physical?
It's an algorithm. We apply certain rates to the number of devices and the number of tags. So at the low end, I mean, the less number of devices and number of tags, the rate is a bit higher. The more devices or number of tags, the rate becomes, I mean, as we grow, the rate lowers. So for big companies, the rate becomes a bit less compared to the one for the small companies. But even for small companies, the price that we are providing is very competitive, because at the end of the day, it's less than the salary of a security analyst. So you have automated security analyst in a box without having to pay their salaries.
One question related with the skills of the production engineers that are going to operate with the solution. How do you feel about the skills they currently have to be able to operate the product?
This is actually one of the basic elements of our USP, because the only skill required for a production engineer is being able to read a screen and know, understand the notification saying, I don't know, port number X, where to find it. What I mean is that they do not have to do any training at all. They simply look at the screen, which tells them exactly what they need to do. So no need for having cybersecurity analyst background, no need for having knowledge of correlating threats and behaviors. You simply see a screen. You can even see this on your mobile phone if you are back home or somewhere else, simply saying what needs to be done in a very plain language and in a very, let's say, actionable notification. So no required skills at all.
One final question. In relation to the team, do you have production engineers or mechanical engineers in the composition of the team?
Our head of development and co-founder, Sadayeti Ramados, has been leading teams for development of software for manufacturers for many years. He has led teams for Nissan, for Bose, for NXP. So his hands-on experience when it comes to embedded software systems for smart manufacturers.
Thank you.
Thank you, George. I think everything is clear.
Thank you so much.